But if a human being comes and says, oh no, later generations believed and they gave this interpretation. So the question is, which came first? The Bible came first or the later generation came first? And I will also explain to you that the Muslim impact upon these issues has been so much that when the Jewish community lived among the Muslims and they were bombarded by these kind of things, especially in Andalus, in Muslim Spain. Ibn Hazm al-Zahiri, how many of you have heard the name of Ibn Hazm? Ibn Hazm. I mean, he was a famous scholar who wrote Kitab al-Milal wal-Ahwa'i wal-Nahl, in which he went through one page of the Bible after the other and quoted them and basically said, how could it be appropriate for God to do such and such or for the prophets to do such and such? So what happens is, you must have heard the name of Musa ibn Maimun, I have quoted. Moses Maimonides, that's what they call. Now, Maimonides wrote his Dalalat al-Ha'irin, or the book of the Guide for the Perplexed, in which he said, this is literal stuff, it does not mean what it says. It must mean something allegorical. And that allegorical we have talked about, you know, how you can explain it out of the context. And from that time on, the Jewish community has taken Maimonides as the authority. And they take all of the allegorical meanings from him, but majority of the Orthodox and majority of the other people who do believe in the Bible, they believe that Maimonides did something horrible to the book itself. So they believe in the stuff which is in the Bible itself. They do not believe in those kind of metaphorical and allegorical stuff. From verse number 24 onward, so Jacob was left alone, and a man wrestled with him till daybreak. When the man saw that he could not overpower him, he touched the socket of Jacob's hip, so that his hip was wrenched as he wrestled with the man. Then the man said, let me go, for it is daybreak. But Jacob replied, I will not let you go unless you bless me. Then man asked him, what is your name? Jacob, he answered. Then the man said, your name will no longer be Jacob, but Israel, because you have struggled with God and with humans and have overcome. Actually, the word is, you have wrestled. Because remember over there, what was that? Wrestling. But in the translation now, somebody, you know, because it's modern translation, so wrestling has been changed into struggle. But still, you have struggled with God. So what is the meaning of the word Israel? You know, the one who struggles against God. Okay. Jacob said, please tell me your name. But he replied, why do you ask my name? Then he blessed him there. So Jacob called the place Peniel, saying, it is because I saw God face to face, and yet my life was spared. Because he does not say, I saw an angel. He does not say, over here there is a man. That man is wrestling. And the fight is so physical, so graphic, that it tells you that the guy, whosoever is fighting with Jacob, he basically played a trick to get his, what? The joint of his, you know, hip off so that he cannot fight. But even then, Jacob was what? Very strong. Now, he says, I saw God face to face, and I was what? Saved. Now, question is, nobody from this text can interpret that this was anybody other than what? God, because it is, I saw God face to face, and I was saved. Now, the question comes, as I've just told you, that if somebody believes that God is like a human being, whose power is limited, and can you imagine wrestling match from the middle of the night or from the beginning of the night till the daybreak? And then, I mean, he's requesting, let me go, because people are going to say, what? You know, God has been, but he says, I will not let you go until you bless me. With all honesty, you know, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talks about Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. وَلَوْ تَقَوَّلَ عَلَيْنَا بَعْدِ الْأَقَابِيلِ لَأَخَذْنَا مِنْهُ بِالْيَمِينِ ثُمَّ لَقَطَعْنَا مِنْهُ الْوَتِينِ. That even if Muhammad sallam just put one word in my mouth, astaghfirullah, not in mouth, but I'm just using the metaphor. If he says one word which I have not revealed to him in my name, I will cut his throat. And who can stop Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? La yusalu amma yafalu wa hum yusalu. Who can ask him, what are you doing? And here the situation is that he is struggling against a human being and then has to beg him the relief in the morning because astaghfirullah, he does not want to show the embarrassment. And these are the books which are supposedly dictated by God and written by Moses. You know it. I mean, that's what I went through, all of those details. And if somebody comes and says, this is not the word of God, this is what the human beings understood from the word of God, I can understand it. But if somebody will come and say, no, this is the word of God, then I will have to ask, I mean, what is God trying to reveal over here? His weakness? Or the strength of Jacob? Or what is God trying to reveal? This is the whole question. There are so many terminologies sometimes, and sometimes it does not make sense, wallah. You ask, is it word of God? Yes. And when you come and pinpoint, then it will come, no, it is the human understanding of God. And finally, Christians will say, oh no, this was the Old Testament. It has been replaced by the New. So what happens is that if it is replaced by the New, then why are you keeping it as the word of God? Say, this is a human word. But everybody is quoting it in their sermons, everybody is talking about. This was there when there was no New Testament. For almost 3 centuries, this was thought to be the word of God taken by the church, and then 27 books were added later on. So how can you say, yarhamukallah, something like that? Okay. Now let's go to, yeah, if you go back to the footnotes, look at the footnotes. Now, what in the footnotes the translator is explaining, Israel probably means he struggles with God. You know what is the meaning of Israel? He struggles with God. I can imagine somebody struggling for God, which is jihad, or struggling in the way of God. I can imagine, but struggling with God. Now this is a respectable word. The word is wrestling, because the same word is used, you know, in the text, you know, for wrestling. And then wrestling with God, for what reason? At the same time. Now, Peniel means face of God. He called the place Peniel. Because you remember the word El and El? In Hebrew language means God. That's where I said Jibreel, Mikael, all of those. So, nobody basically denies. But when it comes to discussion, you will find so many different interpretations and explanations. Number one, the creator and the creature cannot be the same. This is accepted. God is perfect. Human beings are imperfect. We are finite, which is mahdood. He is infinite. He is whatever we are not, because He is the source of all creation. Now, if he needs to come, as some of the Christians say, that he has to come in the shape of a human being to get to know the human beings. When he created them, he did not know them, but he was creating. These are his creation. So God is the one who created. That's what the Quran says. وَلَكَدْ خَلَقْنَا الْإِنسَانَ وَنَعْلَمُ مَا تُوَسْوِسُ بِهِ نَفْسُ وَنَحْنُ أَقْرَبُ إِلَيْهِ مِنْ حَبْلِ الْوَرِيدِ. We have created the human being. وَلَكَدْ خَلَقْنَا الْإِنسَانَ وَنَعْلَمُ مَا تُوَسْوِسُ بِهِ نَفْسُ. And we know even the whispering of his or her heart. وَنَحْنُ أَقْرَبُ إِلَيْهِ مِنْ حَبْلِ الْوَرِيدِ. We are closer to him or her than his or her jugular vein. مَا يَلْفِظُ مِنْ قَوْلٍ إِلَّا لَدَيْهِ رَقِيبٌ عَتِيدٌ. Even a word does not come out of his or her mouth, except that two of the angels are there recording and writing. So knowing the knowledge, this is even the waswasa. Sometimes even human being cannot understand it. But he knows it. يَعْلَمُ خَائِنَةَ الْأَعْيُنِ وَمَا تُخْفِي الصُّدُورِ. He knows the whispering of the heart and the blinking of the eyes. يَعْلَمُ خَائِنَةَ الْأَعْيُنِ وَمَا تُخْفِي الصُّدُورِ. Number two, if God is a human being, human beings have got limit. Number one, you've got a body. Number two, the knowledge is limited. I may not be able to see outside this building. The sight is limited. The power is limited. And the capacities and the attributes are limited. We can get angry. We can get loving. We can be horrible. We can be the best of the human beings. You know, all of these extremes. And we could be just and we could be unjust. So if God comes, number one, he has to be what? Limited to become in a human shape. Because no human body, no human capacity, no human attribute can what? Cover and have the idrak of God Almighty. Now, if this is the situation that he can become a man, then man can become a God. That if God comes and puts most of his power somewhere else and takes upon limited power and limited body and lives among the human beings, then many question comes, who is running the affair while he is here? Who is taking care of?
Because, why he has to give up?
Why he has to give up? Because once he comes in this limited form, he has taken upon himself the limits which apply to humanity. If he is not limited, then he is not human being. Because human beings, their knowledge is limited, their capacity is limited, their attributes are limited. So when he takes this cage, who is running the affairs of the whole world? And where is the rest of his jalala and the majesty? And if the majesty can be contained in this 6 feet, then this 6 feet can go and have the jalala also.